Morning. What time is it? Oh. Oh my gosh. I'm gonna be late. It's graduation day.
Hey, Sam Pam, what's going on?
I thought we were meeting in front of Barton to go to graduation.
Barton? Graduation? It's virtual.
What? Virtual?
Yeah, hello, no, no. I sent you a link.
I'm gonna be late.
Oh, go.
Okay, see ya, bye.
You got it, bye. Sam Pam.
We gotta go.
I really hope we make it in time.
Oh my gosh, I made it. What's going on, guys? Meyerson said there's some type of a virtual graduation.
Oh my gosh. Yeah, it's crazy, right?
2020 will be big, they said. 2020 will be the best, they said. Hold on, is this some kind of a joke? Or something?
Saban, hello, where have you been? COVID-19, quarantine, meeting on the computer screen?
Quarantine? Really? Yes, quarantine. And you've been giving us work on Google Classroom like every single day. So what exactly is going on here? What are we doing?
We gotta get this party started!
That's right. If we can get through this, we can get through anything.
I think there's only one thing left to say.
From our house to yours,
it's graduation day!
Good day, my name is Cisa Escobaras. I'm the Director of Senior Activities at Clara Barton High School. On behalf of our principal, Dr. Richard A. Foreman, and staff, I am pleased to bring you greetings and am honored to begin our commencement exercises. This year might be a little different, and yes, feel a little different, but we're still celebrating you with the same spirit as if we were at our venue, Queens College. Graduates, please rise as Pomp and Circumstance plays and welcome your family to your 2020 graduation. Barton Strong.
We'll be right back. big thank you to the alumni stage band led by Mr. Neverson. Please welcome the voice you have heard for the last 4 years saying these exact words to lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance. Mr. Meyerson.
Thank you, Mr. Holgate. Please stand if you'd like, salute, and pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Meyerson. A former Barton graduate and one of our wonderful guidance counselors will now lead us in the national anthem. Please welcome Ms. Isaacs.
Can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets rang clear, the bombs burst. Still there. Oh, who say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the lands of the free?
Thank you, Miss Isaacs. Please be seated. Actually, you're probably seated already. Yes, this year's graduation will look differently, but we will still bring that Barton energy and Barton spirit, even if it's virtual. So, parent, faculty, distinguished guest, and especially the candidates for graduation, my name is Keith S. Holgate, and I am the Assistant Principal for Pupil Personnel Services here at Clara Barton High School. On behalf of the entire Clara Barton family, it is my distinguished pleasure to welcome you to this auspicious occasion, the Clara Barton Class of 2020 graduation ceremony. At this time, it is my pleasure to introduce our principal, Dr. Richard A. Foreman.
Parents, guardians, honored guest speakers, distinguished faculty, and our sterling students at Clara Barton's graduating class of 2020. My name is Dr. Richard A. Foreman, and I have been honored, humbled, and blessed to have served as a New York City High School principal for the past 20 years. Before we begin, I respectfully ask for a moment of silence to address the deaths of George Floyd and Breonna Taylor, Black Americans' long-standing catastrophic interactions with law enforcement, and the persistent anti-Black racism that has plagued our nation and our educational institutions. Thank you. The diversity of individuals marching the streets around the world in protest is a positive sign that the large number of individuals from all walks of life are realizing that the injustice against any one of us is an injustice against all. Today, June 26, 2020, is a joyful, beautiful summer day, proving the adage that there is light and a glimmer of hope after periods of elongated darkness and despair. I want to take this opportunity to congratulate you upon reaching the milestone of high school graduation. Your diligence, self-motivation, and willingness to seek assistance were key components on this journey, suddenly and calamitously interrupted by the COVID-19 global pandemic. On March 15, 2020, you experienced an abrupt and traumatic separation from your teachers, friends, peer students, and your school, where we spend more than half of every day. You have watched and learned about ongoing dreadful news whereby 800 plus New Yorkers were succumbing to COVID-19 during the months of March and April. As of today, the daily mortality rate has dropped to 20 due to social distancing, extraordinary personal hygiene, and working remotely. Despite the negativity and fear of the unknown, you have stayed the course towards academic success. You are indeed courageous students who have been emboldened to speak up and to speak out. Remember, we are all in this together. The health and well-being of each and every one of us is truly the concerns of all. The theme of my message for the class of 2020 is to possess clear vision, self-assurance, and resiliency, coupled with forward thinking. We look back at the past with nostalgic sentimentality. However, the past is irrevocable. We must face the future with an intentional resolve to succeed. Success only occurs with a deliberate plan. The identical sentiment was captured in an iconic poem by Walt Whitman entitled Song of the Open Road. Afoot and lighthearted, I take to the open road. Health, free the world before me. The long brown path before me leading wherever I choose. Henceforth, I ask not good fortune. I myself am good fortune. Henceforth, I whimper no more, postpone no more. Need nothing. Done with indoor complaints, libraries, querulous criticisms. Strong and content, I travel the open road, the earth that is sufficient. I do not want the constellations any nearer. I know they are very well where they are. I know they suffice for those who belong to them. Still, here I carry my old delicious burdens. I carry them, men and women. I carry them with me wherever I go. I swear it is impossible for me to get rid of them. I am filled with them, and I will fill them in return. The poem's narrator is describing a trip on which he is embarking. He describes himself as being healthy and free, and he realizes that he is the only person who is in complete control of his life. He chooses the path in which to follow. Because of this realization, he does not have to rely solely on hope for good fortune. He will reach his destination with fortitude, courage, and self-determination. He knows that the road is not without danger. However, his intellect, free will, and independence and resolve will lead him along to his destination safely. The open road is something everyone uses. Individuals can come together in a meaningful way where status is of no concern. The road is limitless and allows the traveler full control of his or her fate. This poem is an ode to one's self-reliance. Walt Whitman advocates to remain independent, control your own destiny through self-determination. You have reached a pivotal juncture in your lives where a new world of opportunities awaits. In 3 months, you will be immersed in study at college, university, vocational education, the armed forces, and or private industry. Many of you will be living in new cities without the immediate support of your nuclear families and friends. You will be establishing new friendships and professional relationships. You will be working cooperatively with peers on challenging instructional projects, interfacing with technology, perhaps unknown to us at the present time. Remain steadfast on the journey, no matter how difficult the task, with a clear resolve. Seek a way to complete the project. Communicate your concerns, ask for assistance, learn to prioritize, and take care of your physical and mental health. Sharpen your listening skills. Inattentive and indifferent listening is often the primary cause of miscommunication and conflict. Remember, no one is always right or wrong. Advocate your position in a professional manner. when interacting with unscrupulous individuals, always remain true to your core beliefs, maintain your dignity and reserve at all times. I want to take this opportunity to wish you a lifetime of good health, professional and personal success. Keep the legacy of the class of 2020 alive by maintaining an active role in Clara Barton's High School Alumni Association. We look forward to your returning to our school on December 23rd, 2020 to speak to the class of 2021 at our annual Alumni Day. You will be called upon to speak about the rigors of college life and to urge the current seniors to avoid a case of senioritis. Thank you. I would like to call on Ms. Shondell Lawson, Parent Coordinator, to join in presenting the Council of Supervisors and Administrators Parent Leadership Award.
Good day. My name is Shondell Lawson. I'm the Parent Coordinator of Clara Barton High School. I want to congratulate Class of 2020. And I want to thank my parents for allowing me to service their kids. I want to also wish them good luck in the future. And today we only have one parent award. And the CSA award goes to Ms. Marcy Roberts. Thank you and congratulations, Ms. Roberts.
Hello all. My name is Marcy Roberts, the PTA president of Clara Barton High School for 2 years. I would like to wish the graduating class congratulations on your future endeavors. Stay strong, stay healthy, and stay safe.
Thank you, Dr. Foreman and Ms. Lawson, and congrats to Ms. Roberts. On Wednesday, June 17th, 2020, Clara Barton held its annual Senior Awards. There were some awards where the recipients were not selected at that time. Here is another of our wonderful guidance counselor, Ms. Farberman, to announce the recipients.
And a special congratulations to our award winners. For the Chancellor's Roll of Honor and Scholarship, Becky Paul Odenhin. The Chancellor's Roll of Honor and Attendance, Cora Dubois. The Chancellor's Roll of Honor and Community Service, Nathaya Roberts. The PTA Awards, Nathaya Roberts, Brianna Lawson, and Becky Paul Odenhin. And a special congratulations to Melvin Ward. He has won the following awards: Outstanding Excellence in Work Study, Attendance, Mathematics, and Social Studies. Excellence in Living Environment, Teresa Maria Ariola. Excellence in Economics, Eniola Olalekan.
Thank you, Ms. Farberman, and congratulations to the awardees. Ms. Savannah Williams will now address you as the salutatorian for the class of 2020.
Good day, Dr. Foreman, faculty, staff, parents, guardians, family, friends, and most importantly, the class of 2020. First, I'd like to start by thanking God and all the families, friends, teachers, counselors, and advisors who helped us arrive at this moment. They have all had a tremendous impact on the development of the graduates today. And although I know this is not how we originally looked forward to arriving at this moment, I feel it is safe to say they have all had a profound effect on our journey. I am proud to say that through this daunting experience, we have not only continued to advance our academics, but in our spirit. We have pushed past limits that people never thought we could. It is a blessing to see how much we have accomplished. Being here together today and celebrating how far we have come these past 4 years is both a humbling and exciting experience. When I think of the class of 2020, I think of power, strife, and invincibility. As a class, we have demonstrated strength, unity, and determination. Not even a worldwide pandemic can strip those qualities from us. If anything, it has made us stronger. Let us not forget our tenacity and our willpower to complete this long and difficult task. You know what's crazy? The last time we were at Clara Barton, we didn't know it would be the last time many of us would be seeing each other. And that's a painful thought. However, I am filled with anticipation and enthusiasm because I know that every single one of you have the potential to succeed in every aspect of your life. You have not only proven that at Clara Barton, but to the world. You have proven that you can surpass every obstacle that life throws at you. You can achieve any goal you set your mind to and make any dream you wish to happen come true. and sometimes it's not always easy. Often we could see the journey, but not the mountaintop. We could see the mountaintop, but don't know the journey we should take. But I say this with 100% confidence. With God on our side, our family surrounding us, and with the right mindset, it doesn't matter what people may say or what curveballs may come your way. You will succeed. You are incomparable, extraordinary, and with faith, you can move mountains. Our years at Clara Barton have been interesting. They were tiring, stressful, rewarding, and pleasurable all at the same time. We were granted the opportunity to learn and to acquire knowledge as well to experience life lessons. I know it's not always easy to stay motivated in school, but attending class and obtaining knowledge are not only what school offered. Clara Barton gave the opportunity to meet new people, to develop our social skills, and to provide a head start for our future. We have had the chance to instill a new perspective in our lives, a perspective of bettering ourselves and our mindset. We have learned to be happy for others and their successes, and to motivate ourselves as well as our peers. I say all this to say, you are stronger than you might think you are. You are more than the eyes can see. The class of 2020 is a family. And believe it or not, many are looking up to us. They are witnessing our perseverance and counting on us to continuously be an example to every child and every adult who may feel like giving up or is unmotivated to reach their true potential. More than ever, this is a time for us to come together and be a city upon a hill so that anyone who needs a reminder to keep going, they will always remember who we are and what the class of 2020 has accomplished. I would like to conclude by congratulating all my fellow graduates and to express our gratitude for all the support we have received. You are one of a kind, and nothing could take that away from you. Continue to prosper and strive for better. What we thought was a barrier shaped us for our purpose. It has strengthened us, motivated us, and gave us a different perspective on life. I know we will do great things in the future, greater than we could ever imagine. I will miss all of you. Class of 2020! Congratulations. Graduates, please rise for the Young Citizens Pledge. Raise your right hand and repeat after me. With gratitude to my school, with pride in my city, and with devotion to my country, I pledge, as a graduate, to cherish the tradition of Clara Barton High School for Health Professions. I pledge, as a citizen, to work both alone and with many, to improve my city, and as an American, to obey my country's laws, and to support and defend its constitution. Thank you. Congratulations, Class of 2020.
Thank you, Savannah. It is now my pleasure to introduce our Brooklyn Borough President, Mr. Eric L. Adams, to address the Class of 2020.
I am Brooklyn Borough President Eric Adams, and on behalf of the Borough of Brooklyn, I want to congratulate you, the graduating class of 2020. This is probably not the graduation you are expecting. Every generation has its own unique challenges across the globe, but it's the lessons learned from overcoming them that brings us closer together and help us thrive. From Pearl Harbor and World War II to 9/11 and now COVID-19, each and every generation can rise with resiliency in the face of tragedy. We are capable of acting as one and moving forward together, not just as classmates and peers, but as human beings. If there's anything that COVID-19 is teaching us, it is that we can face any challenge if we stand strong and work together to meet it head on. Class of 2020, this is your unique challenge. The end of any chapter in your life will rarely look the way you first envisioned it, but that's okay. It is our ability to adapt that creates the foundation of our future. You have reached a wonderful milestone that required endurance and resilience. And those same abilities will help you to adapt to the globe around you. This will not be the last time you have to adapt to circumstances beyond your control, but you are now more ready than ever to face whatever else life throws at you. This is your time. This is your moment. Congratulations, class of 2020. We look forward to seeing your continued determination, creativity, and inspiration as you change the globe for the better.
Thank you, President Adams. It is my pleasure to introduce our New York Senator, who is the Minority Leader of the United States Senate. Senator Chuck Schumer will address the class of 2020.
Hello to Clara Barton High School. This is Senator Chuck Schumer, and it's my honor to address the teachers and staff, families and friends of the graduates, but most of all, you, the class of 2020. Now, I'm really sorry that I can't join you in person, but I'm grateful that modern technology allows us to still be connected on this very special day. The fact that we're all finding new ways to do things, like celebrating this graduation virtually, just goes to show you that New Yorkers won't let anything stop us from honoring what's so important in life. Now, first, I'd like to say a word to the parents. Nothing will take away your decades of hard work raising your children, for which they and all of us are so very grateful. And while this day may be tempered by worries about the future, at least there's one silver lining. You're not seated way in the back. You get to sit next to your son or daughter and give them a hug as they receive their diploma and become an adult before your very eyes. So congratulations to the moms and dads. Now to the class of 2020. As we all know, these are really difficult times, perhaps more difficult than most of us have ever experienced, a global pandemic, an unprecedented economic slowdown, and the urgent need to confront head-on the bigotry and inequality in our society. Right now, the uncertainty of the present and future is scary. You may not know what's going to come next, but one thing's always been certain. As you begin to go through life, there will always be new opportunities. And some will appear in ways you never imagined. It's natural to fear the unknown, but don't let the uncertainty of this current moment prevent you from finding those opportunities, reaching out and grabbing them. They're out there, and don't forget, you have incredible assets, great education, and loving families who will always have your back through thick and thin. You have the passion to change the world, and we have faith in you. So to the graduates, I say, never stop fighting for what you believe in. Congratulations, good luck, and Godspeed.
Thank you, Senator Schumer. Miss Shirley Belval will now address you as the valedictorian for the class of 2020.
Good day, Dr. Foreman, faculty and staff, parents, guardians, family, friends, but most importantly, the class of 2020. I know this is weird for me too, standing in front of a laptop addressing all of you, but if there's anything that we've learned during this time, is to always adapt. So here we go. So congratulations again, the class of 2020. Guys, we did it. I understand this may be a bit underwhelming for you, but 4 years spent in high school and then this. As I reminisce, I remember some of the things I took for granted during high school, such as the day before school coming in to get our schedules, the long lines for MetroCards on the first day, the Barton parties, the food sales, the lunch breaks spent in the hallways, the Franklin Deli sandwiches, our freedom. But who knew the last few months of school boiled down to this? When I first heard that I was the valedictorian, I was happy. But I expected another reaction from myself, to be completely honest. I thought I would be shouting and jumping like most people when I heard the news, but I had maybe a 7 second high of excitement. But on that 8th second, I was just content. You might think that is unappreciative, but that is genuinely how I felt. I held on to that feeling that I felt on the 8th second, as well as the news, for a few days, and I didn't tell anyone, and I just reflected on why I felt that way. And upon being confirmed through prayer, I realized that the reaction I had on that 8th second was a moment of realization that this title was not just the fruit of my hard work. It was the fruit of all the people who loved and supported me during the past 4 years of high school. I realized that if it were just up to my own strength, I would not be in this position today. I realized that I was able to accomplish this goal and many others because of the people in my life. At times when things were overwhelming, or when I honestly had just no energy to even care, my relationship with God first and the people around me were constantly reaffirming and encouraging me. They were sometimes brutally honest, but it was a lot of love and respect. People saw things in me that I didn't always see in myself. And so I want to ask you one question. When something is going on in your life, after those seconds, minutes, or hours of natural human response, on that eighth second after, or just second after, who are those people in your life that you call? With COVID-19 having us all at home and the world slowly reopening, there is no better time to reflect on yourself and the people in your circle. Analyze those relationships in your life. Do they encourage you? Do they speak positively in your life? Do they challenge you? Are they honest with you even when you don't like it, and demonstrate by their actions that they value you? In that same respect, ask yourself about the people you yell best friend to in the hallways. Have you checked up on them since quarantine began? Have you extended your love to those who you know are struggling with either mental or physical health issues? Or just reached out to someone you know who just needs a person to talk to? It is not every day, wake up, shower, Netflix, and sleep. Please check up on people and build relationships and let those people know that you value them and that you care about them. We were not put on this earth to just be surrounded by people. We need to make the best of the time we have and build connections. If these past few months have taught me anything, it is that tomorrow is not always promised. Tell your parents, your teachers, your friends, your after-school club advisors, thank you for loving you, for watching out for you, for giving you a shoulder to cry on, and for telling you to go to class instead of hiding out in the hallway and staircase. And yes, I'm talking about all the times that y'all sat or stood in groups of five or more and made it impossible for anyone to pass through the stairwell or the hallways. Yes, you guys, it was all us at one time. But tell those teachers thank you. For me, I give thanks to God first and foremost for everything, for getting me here today to even see this day after a crazy 4 years. But after God, I thank all the amazing people in my life, all my amazing teachers, my crazy Gateway family, my actual family, my friends, my program advisors and counselors. I say thank you so much. Your support was not in vain. And even to those with broken relationships, go back and apologize. Humble yourself. Put down your pride. Let the past be the past. As we go forward, there is no room for a prolonged infancy. Let's leave the childish behaviors and habits in the past. Let us all progress. Let us grow. Let us discover our passions. And let's become better. Let us become the example that we want to see in our life. Let us reflect on the habits we have. Now that quarantine is slowly easing off, are we coming out of this the same way that we went in? We may not be perfect, but we can always keep progressing. Yes, we all leave Barton as graduates, but most importantly, what connections, knowledge, and the memories that we have made will stick around forever? How will those imprint on our lives and be with us after we depart the building that we've called home, or sometimes even hell, for the past 4 years? I want you all to just think about one crazy or fun experience that high school has left you with. And I want you to hold on to that, and I want you to cherish it. It could be just roaming the building during lunch, the little dance parties in the staircase, the deep conversations we've had with friends, the bathroom and staircase meetups, the after-school food runs, or even the virtual prom we've recently had. I want you to remember it, and I want you to hold on to it. I want you to remember it, but allow yourself to build newer and better memories. Let these things put a smile on your face or give you a laugh every time you think of them. In conclusion, every day that we wake up, we should decide to be a better sibling, child, student, friend, overall a better person. Class of 2020, we are an interesting group. We could turn up when we want to, but at the same time, we can accomplish wonders when we set our minds to do it. We are the future healthcare professionals, lawyers, makeup artists, entrepreneurs, scientists, architects, advocates. We are the future. We made it to the end of high school, guys, and if life has not done so already, it is about to hit you. These past few weeks, and honestly, our whole lives, have shown us that our blackness is not always respected. We will be in settings where no one looks like us, where we are looked at like we are inferior. But I urge you to learn your history, not just what is put in the textbooks, but the things that are unspoken. We are powerful. Individually, we are strong. But together, we are unstoppable. Learn to advocate for yourself. Speak up for yourself respectfully and be unapologetically you. Go out there, shine, and do your thing because you can. The way was paved for us so that we could. So go out and do it. And if no one has ever told you this before, I will. I believe in you. I'm proud of you for making it this far. You are and will be amazing. But most importantly, you are loved by a king. Set your eyes forward. Grow. Beautiful things are ahead. I love you, class of 2020.
Thank you, Shirley. LIU Gear Up has been a part of this graduating class since day one. In fact, some of you may have been interacting with them in your junior high school. Miss Oluwase, also known to us as Miss Shea, will say a few words.
Congratulations, class of 2020. You did it. LIU Gear Up is so proud of you. You have proven to be determined, resilient, and able to overcome whatever obstacles came your way, especially during these uncertain times in our country and in our world. In April 2017, you signed a banner saying, Class of 2020, I know I can. And who knew that message would be so profound during uncertain times? Thanks for allowing us to be a part of your high school experience. We truly enjoyed making memories with you through dance, through basketball, through being in room 405, through Saturday Academy, college trips, and so many other things that we did. As you go to college, to the workforce, to the military, or whatever else may come your way, we truly hope that you will never forget the message that I know I can. Because regardless of what challenges come your way, know that you will be able to succeed if you are determined to do so. Congratulations, class of 2020. You did it, and we are so proud of you.
Thank you, Shay. And thanks to LIU Gear Up for supporting the class of 2020. Like Shay said, you pledge, yes, I can, and she'll be following up on you guys to make sure that you still can, even in college. At this time, please welcome Miss Marion Finn, another of our counselors, who, although retired, is still working with us and is here to introduce our keynote speaker.
Hello, everyone. It is my honor to introduce our guest speaker today. Trailblazer, groundbreaker, innovator, risk taker, advocate. Choose any one. I say choose all of them because they pretty much define this amazing young woman who you will meet today. She's one of our own. She's a graduate of the class of 1995. She sat in the same classrooms you sat in. She walked the same hallways, and she suffered through the torturous college process. She attended Barnard and Columbia Universities and Fordham School of Law. The law became her passion. It would open doors for young people of diverse backgrounds to pursue a career in law. Presently, she serves on the board of directors at Fordham Law School, and she's an adjunct professor of law at Fordham. After several years at a prestigious law firm, where she was the first Latina to make law partner, she took a giant leap of faith, a risk, and joined a global law firm, Sidley Austin, where she is the director of East Coast Diversity. She travels extensively to engage a diverse group of young people, the underrepresented, the underserved, a rainbow of young people. As chair of Aspira, a youth leadership organization, and the first ever president of the Sonia and Selena Sotomayor Judicial Internship Program, actually, two Clara Barton students were accepted to this program. Through these programs, she continues her mission of inclusion for all to find their passion in the practice of law. She is a gifted Latina, Puerto Rican strong. As her very proud counselor, it is my pleasure to introduce Rosvely Marquez Morales.
Congrats, Clara Barton, class of 2020. A special welcome to our graduates, their families, friends, and the wonderful Clara Barton professionals that have helped each of you make it to graduation. As an alum, I am honored to speak to you today as your keynote speaker, but mostly as a woman of color. I am Rosvely Marquez Morales, and I was born in Puerto Rico and raised in Old Williamsburg. I graduated from Clara Barton in 1995, and with the help of a wonderful guidance counselor, Marianne Fim, I received a full scholarship to join Barnard College of Columbia University. I then went on to study law at Fordham School of Law. Like many young students, I went to law school to become a public servant. But law school took me in a different direction, and I went into a private law firm where I found myself back in the health profession, but this time representing them as a lawyer. I then became the first Latina partner of a 250-lawyer firm. After 15 years of practicing, I made the difficult decision to leave the partnership and pursue a passion of diversifying the legal profession. I joined a global law firm of over 1,900 lawyers to serve as their diversity director, where I oversee their D&I initiatives related to the recruitment, training and development, and the retention of women and diverse lawyers. Now, many people ask me, why would you leave a partnership? I think President Obama described my reason the best when he said, "Change will not come if we wait for some other person or some other time. We are the ones we've been waiting for. We are the change that we seek." So my message today is to become the leader your community needs by empowering those around you to reach their highest potential. At this moment in history has shown us, statistically, the odds of graduating from high school are not with communities of color. But today, on this moment, we celebrate you, your hard work, and your perseverance. Today marks a major turning point in your life as you embark on the phase of a young adulthood. It is the beginning of your journey and not the end. Your choices today and beyond will be your own and shape your future. At this time, I challenge you to reflect on the history of this country and pay tribute to the contributions of our Black, Latino, Asian, LGBTQ, and other members of underrepresented groups that have made in shaping America's culture and achievements. It is an opportunity for all Americans to celebrate success of generations of minorities from law and military to public service, to health, to business, education, and the arts. We have enriched our nation's heritage, and we are the youngest and fastest growing segment of our population, representing a vital and thriving part of our country's future. As I speak with you today, I want you to think about your legacy as an individual, but most importantly, as a leader in our society. While being the first Latina partner was significant, it did very little for our legacy as a community. But as our role as community leaders, it is to make sure that I am not the first one, but that there are others that can pave the way, right? That it is their hard work and perseverance to serve as a roadmap for many to follow. To many minority students are not reaching maximum potential. It's not due to lack of talent amongst our communities, but lack of access to information, knowledge of your rights and your options, and sometimes lack of encouragement. My role and our role as a community is to cultivate you as leaders, leaders that will ultimately define and broaden our legacy. So my vision is similar to many community leaders that seek to foster the development of committed individuals who engage in the growth of our community and ultimately build our legacy. Because it truly takes a village to raise and cultivate future generations. So everyone here needs to be a part of the solution, which goes beyond sponsoring or supporting any one group, but it really requires all of us to actively educate, cultivate, mentor, empower, and guide our future generations so they are inspired to build our legacy as a community. In closing, I want you to stay positive and have faith in yourself, your abilities, and in our society. With our world being plagued with illness, racism, economic depression, and severe mental health issues, it is very easy to feel helpless and unsure about your future. But I'm here to remind you that in the darkest moments, we must all believe that we have a purpose, more meaningful and bigger than today. Our job today is to prepare ourselves for the future you want, because you are that future that will make a difference. It will be your kindness, your faith, your skills that will guide us into a more fair, just, and brighter tomorrow. For this future that you deserve, you must be brave, you must show courage, and you must be the change that you want. Take a look around you. Here are your future doctors, your nurses, your engineers, your lawyers, your teachers, your elected officials, chefs, actors, therapists, and most importantly, leaders. During these years, you have built a community of friends, teachers, counselors, and individuals who will support you. Maintain those connections. Remember, who you are in this moment will not define who you will be. Who you will be defined by your values, your beliefs, your hard work, and your perseverance. Finally, remember, you are Barton Strong. We do not give up, we push forward, and we shine bright because we have a faith and we have a village that will help uplift you and those around you. Remember to lead by example through your actions. Thank you for inviting me to speak today. I hope I have sparked some thought of how you can contribute. And please do stay in touch via LinkedIn as I look forward to seeing all the wonderful things that you will all accomplish. Stay healthy, stay positive. Best of love to you and your families.
Thank you, Ms. Finn and Ms. Morales. We always appreciate it when our alumni come back home. You know, Ray Charles once said, music is powerful, and as people listen to it, they can be affected. We felt it was fitting to choose one of our senior MA students whose voice was described as angelic by our music teacher, Ms. Patrizio. Let's see how her music will affect you. Please put your hands together and let's welcome Ms. Erica Peer.
All the memories of everything we've been through.
Thank you, Erica. This year's senior class is in the history books for many reasons. Let's welcome your senior class president, Ms. Esther Williams, to say a few words.
Good morning, family, friends, Dr. Foreman, esteemed faculty and staff members, our lovely speakers, and of course, the amazing class of 2020. Congratulations to us. We did it, guys. The day we've been waiting for since September of 2016 is finally here. Yes, I can guarantee we've all said it feels like just yesterday we were sitting in the hot auditorium listening to Mr. Holgate for our freshman orientation. I am honored to be the class president of such an exceptional group of students, and I thank you for giving me the opportunity to serve you. I would first like to acknowledge the other outstanding members of our 2020 Senior Council, Crystalina Francois, our secretary, Maureen Lumos, our vice president. Thank you for all your hard work and dedication. I could not have asked for a better team. I would also like to thank the staff that truly supported us this year. Ms. Escoboris, Ms. Antoine, Mr. Myerson, Ms. Lawson, Ms. Jarvis, and Ms. Isaacs. We couldn't have done it without you. I have to also thank LIU Gear Up for the dedication they have given to the class of 2020's future by getting us ready for college since freshman year and in junior high school for some of you. Lastly, we must thank our families, our mothers, our fathers, brothers, sisters, grandparents, aunts and uncles, and those that failed those rules when our families could not. Thank you for all of your support and encouragement. Most importantly, thank you for believing in us when we didn't even believe in ourselves. We love you and we don't know what we would do without you. I would like to personally thank my parents for always telling me, face your books instead of going on Facebook. At the beginning of my speech, I said, we've been ready to graduate since September of 2016. However, no high school student ever realizes how fast that day actually arrives until they actually live it. No matter how many speeches we hear that say, the 4 years go by so fast, it's something we must realize and reflect on by ourselves. We will miss all the talent shows, the parties, the spirit days, and spending time with each other, whether it was in the hallway, class, or the lunchroom. Most importantly, we're gonna miss those free Metro cards. Miss Agard, could you hook a sister up? We're leaving high school to go to a place where we will have to pay for public transportation, not hear any morning announcements by Mr. Myerson, no teachers that care enough to call your parents about how you're doing in their class. Also, we have to pay for school, something I don't think any of us, including our families, are ready for. But we can do it, and we will make it, because that is what the class of 2020 does and always has done. We persevere when the odds are against us, and even still, when all hope is lost. That is why there's no class that can possibly be better than ours. Furthermore, the class of 2020 can't reflect on our senior year without mentioning COVID-19. It is an unforgettable part of our story. Pop Smoke once said, "Take your pain and make champagne with it." This pandemic was our pain. It took away from our senior year, forced us to change, get used to Google Classroom, and lose many loved ones whose souls I pray rest in peace. But all of those things only made us stronger. Through all of it, we managed to make a champagne bottle even bigger than the pain that we went through. There's so much more to celebrate than to be sad about. Being alive and here today to watch this as history is being made is enough to be thankful for. Police brutality against us has been brought to light, and all races marching on behalf of our people. Our ancestors are dancing right now as shouts for justice, peace, and black pride and power fill the air. And we were a part of this movement, our year, 2020. We are the generation of students that will very soon fill the great professions in this country so that the systems put in place to treat us unjustly can do that no longer. From among us will emerge amazing doctors, nurses, lawyers, judges, police officers, entrepreneurs, teachers, professors, scientists, designers, actors, and CEOs, because we are the generation of change. So yes, the class of 2020 may have had a lot of reasons to be sad this year, but we still have far more reasons to be thankful. The numbers 2020 symbolize perfection, and I can't think of a more appropriate way to describe this class. And on that note, class of 2020, we did this, and there is no graduating class that is as brilliant, resilient, and diligent as we are. And that's on period. Congratulations, guys.
That was great so far.
I love Shirley's speech. Well, I don't think mine was that bad. Yes, Queen, yes! I love the guest speaker.
How about Savannah? She was a great speaker, too.
What's next? Can't wait.
I think we need to take a look back at what Cena's got to do so far.
I'm in.
say hello. Looking at the cornrows up in the club. Girl, don't be bashful, girl, back it up. Throw it, girl, like it's potent, man. Shake that.
Cubans with the Jesus piece. Thank with you. My piece packing, asking who want it. You got it, flaunt it. That Brooklyn bull, we on it.
Biggie, 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 can't you see? Sometimes your words just hypnotize me. And I just love your flashy ways. Guess that's why they're broken, you're so mean. Biggie, 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 can't you see? Sometimes your words just hypnotize me. And I just love your flashy ways. Guess that's why they're broken.
Last time we bought it, only said the road. I'm the one with the road. Third form, me say, me try a thing. And you know it formed up to be a fire thing. Now up on stage with chronic, say, I sing. Yeah, see me all diggy soon, get the higher ring. Like, hello, brother, me say, I had to shout ya. Saw your poster, spectacular photo. Keep it burning, yes, that's the motto. If me the butter, pass through your soul. To gamble in a life, man. Me have to...
I get the comments with number that's period. I got your B on one, put on the mirrors. First young in the A2 land, run a 14 mil, started 14 grams. Dope boy diggers and diamonds and Tim, you shouldn't play with that boy, he is not one of them.
Bro, I kept taking L's, finally got me an M. Still making double, I don't call what I spend. S550 2018, gotta come 20 if you hopping in the Benz. Young Turk, from the D to the A, I'm rocking with the Lions.
Yeah, I'm rocking with the Braves. Yeah, we pay.
Yeah, we pay.
I'ma turn it up a little more this time, you should dream back in.
Up and I shake the room.
TV, sunset done changed ever since we was on. I dreamed it all ever since I was young. They said I won't be nothing. Now they always say congratulations. Worked so hard, forgot how to vacation. They ain't never had the dedication. People hating, say we changing. Look, we made it. Yeah, we made it.
They was never friendly. Yeah, now I'm jumping out of Bentley. Yeah, and I know I sound dramatic. Yeah, but I know I had to have it. Yeah, for the money I'm a savage. Yeah, I be itching like I had it. Yeah, I'm surrounded 20 bags. Yeah, but they didn't know me last year. Yeah, everyone wanna act like they important, but all that mean nothing when I saw my door. Yeah, everyone counting on me, drop the ball. Yeah. Everything custom like I'm at the bottom. Yeah, yeah. If you with winning, would you light us to the sky? How could I make sense when I got millions on my mind? Coming with it, with it, I just put it to the side. Bought a sensor, baby, they could see it in my eyes. My mama called, see you on TV. Sunset done changed ever since we was on. I dreamed it all. Ever since I was young, they said I won't be nothing. Now they always say congratulations. Worked so hard, forgot how to vacation. They ain't never had the dedication. People hating, say we changing. Look, we made it. Yeah, we made it.
I was patient, yeah.
I was patient. Hey, Now I can scream that we made it. Now everywhere I go, they say congratulations. Young graduation. Yeah. I pick up the rock and I ball, baby. I'm looking for someone to call, baby. But right now I got a situation. Never old being frank. Big rings, champagne. My life is like a ball game. But instead I'm in a trap, though. Pot so big, call it Super Bowl. Super Bowl, caught up. Get in the rows. Top flow lifestyle. Hacho and Post.
How do I say goodbye to...
I would like to wish the graduating class of 2020 best wishes ever. I know that you guys have been through a lot and you've had a lot of courage, strength, and resilience. And these are the qualities that will help you through this transitioning period to your new phase in life. All the best in your future endeavors.
Hello, seniors of 2020. Congratulations on reaching this milestone. I know it's been a hard year. I've had most of you, or a lot of you, as students. I miss you all. Congratulations, class of 2020.
Hey, class of 2020, congratulations. You made it through a hell of a year. You guys made it through 2020 and managed to graduate no matter what was going on. So you guys are the MVPs. Don't ever stop. Your voices will always be heard. And make this world a better place. Congratulations, class of 2020. Barton Strong.
Class of 2020, be smart, stay safe, stay strong, stay blessed.
Congratulations, class of 2020. You did it. Woohoo!
Let me stop this. This is what we prepared you for. Congratulations to the class of 2020. All the best to the best. You are the best. Go and continue to be your very best. Congratulations to you, the class of 2020.
Hi, everybody, from Ms. Kalu. I hope everybody's fine, following the procedures, the mask, the gloves, the extra mask, and doing everything to keep yourself safe and healthy in these unprecedented times. Okay, stay well.
Hi everyone, Miss Sapan here with Dre the cat. I just wanted to say congratulations to the class of 2020. I am so proud of all of you. You've all worked so hard, you've been through so much, and today is the day that we celebrate you. I miss you all. I know it's been a rough few months, but you did it! So congratulations and have a great summer. Bye.
Class of 2020, what can I say about you? You guys will forever be known as the first. You were the first to have to leave school in the midst of a pandemic, and now the first to go 100% virtual learning, virtual prom, and now a virtual graduation. You will forever be known as trailblazers. Approach this world with that same mentality. Go out there and blaze trails that aren't necessarily set for you. The time is now and it is yours. Seize it. Antoine, miss you, love you, out.
Hey seniors, Mr. Briganti here. I just want to give a quick shout out to you guys for completing your senior year. Wow, what a journey it has been. I'm sure that you are feeling just astounded and curious for what the future holds. And I want to say from the bottom of my heart, thank you. You guys have shown me so much about myself. You have allowed me to be myself in the classroom. And for that, I truly cannot thank you enough. It has been a wild ride this year. We have done so much together, and I'm blown away by how incredible and intelligent and wise and just funny you all have been, and it has meant a lot to me. Obviously, I haven't been able to work with all the seniors, but this video is mainly for my Gateway seniors, so shout out my Gateway seniors. But I do just want to say thank you, guys, and I also want to say that college is not ready for you. You have so much that you can offer them. You're smart. You are passionate. You are well-spoken. You are well-thought. And I know that you will excel in college, and I can't wait to see what happens in your future. So as always...
Behind every cloud, there is a silver lining. If COVID-19 is a cloud, then you, class of 2020, have found the silver lining. The silver lining of your persistence, your resilience, your tenacity, and your determination to succeed against all odds. You have been tried and found worthy. As you move through the next phases of your life, take that fighting spirit with you. It will serve you well along your journey. Congratulations, class of 2020. It has been an honor to work with you.
Thank you, Esther, and thank you to the production team for looking back at our graduating class. At this time, I'd like to pull your attention to the wall outside our guidance office. Actually, as you know, our new name for the guidance office is the Alistair Thomas Guidance Suite. Now, outside the wall, there's a sign that says, "Success is a journey, not a destination." I think that it's a very applicable saying to you graduates here today. In 2016, Ms. Finn and I selected students who had applied to Clara Barton High School. In September of that year, we had an assembly and we looked down at the 300 lost, nervous, and confused souls whom we selected to attend Clara Barton. Yes, I'm talking about you guys. It's been 4 years. And as I sit here and look at the list of the successful 200 plus of the 300, I say a hearty well done. You have made Miss Finn and I, you have made Miss Finn and me proud to have selected you. But back to the saying, I know everyone sees the diploma, the cap and gown, the awards, and how successful and excited you all are today as you sit at home with your family. But this is the destination. What about the journey or the road you traveled to get to this point? It brings to mind a song by reggae artist Buju Banton. It's not an easy road. Many see the glamour and the glitter and they think a better road. Yeah, who feels it knows. All right, all right, all right. You get the point. So I stop singing before I clear your living rooms. But seriously, I know that it wasn't always an easy road for you all to get to where you are today. And that's in addition to the recent coronavirus pandemic and the recent social injustice unrest. There were hills and valleys, hurdles, stumbling blocks along the way, but you overcame them. Even the honor roll students, the valedictorian, the salutatorian, the advanced regent students, the health career students, and all the labeled bright students had their hurdles to overcome in order to maintain expectations. I want to take a few minutes to address some of those obstacles that many of you faced and recognize a few individuals who did not allow these hurdles to hold them back. First of all, it's not easy to try to fit into the American culture when English is not your primary language. We just haven't reached the maturity level here in this country where the ability to speak more than one language is seen as an achievement. Yet, we have many of you who, despite being pushed into ESL classes throughout your school lives, are not only graduating here today, but with top honors. To everyone in this category, I say well done and congratulations. Representing this group is a young lady who came from Haiti to this country when she was 12 years old. She did not speak English. She said she read a lot and she studied a lot of vocabulary words. She said that she was determined to learn the language. She built a friendship with a couple of students after she graduated from middle school and came here to Clara Barton. And that experience helped her to adjust to the new culture. I asked her what advice she had for new immigrants. And she said that they should read a lot. They shouldn't be upset or turned off when things got hard, because they will also be fun times. Most importantly, she advised them, you have to be patient. She did not merely go with the flow, but was always concerned about her academic future. She was a constant visitor to my office after each report card over the years. She cried, she laughed, she worried, and we planned. She focused, she went to tutoring, and she participated in whatever activities we discussed as ways to help her stay on track. She made it. And she's among us today as a 2020 graduate. Please give it up for Miss Christina Gideon. Congratulations, Christina. Your mom told me that she's very proud of you. You know, adults always say that if they had a chance to relive their teenage lives, they would be perfect adults. But that is not so. They're thinking of being back as a teenager with their adult brain and their adult experiences, now that which they now have. But that's impossible. And some of the same mistakes would be made. I could select any one of you graduates here today to represent this group. I'm thinking about fighting with negative peer pressure, perceived family issues, teenage crises, and overall school and lives issues. In the middle of all these hurdles, you're supposed to be an A+ student and graduate. The student whom I'm selecting to represent this group overcame all these obstacles and is one of our 2020 graduates. She credits her success and turnaround to her grandmother, Miss Angela Pfaff, and also to her guidance counselor, Miss Trim. To her grandmother, she says, thanks for being there for me and supporting me. Please give it up for Miss Jessica Watson. Congratulations, Jessica. We're proud of you. You know, supporting our graduates in their homes today are a lot of parents and guardians. I know some just simply couldn't make it today for whatever reason, but I also know that some couldn't make it physically, even though they're here in spirit. It is sad and hard to lose a parent, a guardian, a family member, or a mentor at any time in your life. I'm talking not only due to the coronavirus, but some of our graduates had lost family members before the pandemic started. Losing a loved one is especially hard when you're trying to focus on high school graduation. Just think of the emotional hurdles these students had to overcome. This is definitely not an easy road. Yet, they made it. And I'm sure their loved ones are looking down on them today with a big smile filled with pride. Ladies and gentlemen, please help me to recognize a young lady representing this group. Like most girls, this young lady and her dad were extremely close. Her mother describes her as a sweetheart who cares so much about people that she puts them first above herself. After her father passed away 2 years ago, she harnessed the helplessness she felt into a conviction to pursue a profession in health career so she can give the help to others that she wasn't able to give to her father. She told me that conviction gave her the desire, strength, and perseverance to succeed in high school. please give it up for our graduate, Miss Kaya Hamilton. Congrats, Kaya. Well done. I know your dad is proud of you. Congratulations to all those who have lost close family members recently and yet maintained focus to join us today as proud graduates of the class of 2020. Bob Marley says, when one door is closed, others are open. While we thank and congratulate the parents watching today, I want to take this opportunity to thank all the other family members who stepped up and supported these youngsters when death closed one door for them. So let's recognize adopted and foster parents. Let's recognize grandparents. Please, let's recognize step parents. Let's recognize aunts and uncles. Yes, let's recognize older brothers and sisters. And let us also recognize family, friends, and all others. Congratulations to all. Finally, your journey through college and throughout life will not be an easy road. You will face several hurdles in your lives. Please attack them like you did in high school. Always have faith. Remember, life is a journey, and give thanks when you reach your destination. Be always mindful of the less fortunate. One love, and as my granny always say, walk good. Thank you. At this time, I'm asking the class of 2020 to please stand, turn around towards your family and friends who are with you. Family members, at this time, please take a few moments to acknowledge your child's achievement. As Assistant Principal of Pupil Personnel Services, I am honored to present to you our 2020 candidates for graduation. The candidates for graduation will now be called by the guidance counselors.
Good evening. My name is Carlene Petit, one of the guidance counselors fortunate to work with some of the highest quality young men and women graduating today. You are my first graduating class, and I want you to remember to follow the passion in your heart. Believe in who you are and that there is a purpose for you to accomplish great things. You have mastered the objectives and passed all the exams for this phase of your life. Now it's up to you to make it happen and create the life you want to represent who you are. I will miss seeing the smiles and the familiar faces in my office. Congratulations, class of 2020, and congratulations to the families, because without your support, we wouldn't be here today. Ladies and gentlemen, I have the honor to begin the presentation of our graduates. Ayana Abdul-Mateen, Ted Manuela Abumu, Joanna Achipong, Xavion Adams, Jennifer Aguilar, Virjana Ahmed, Samantha Alexander, Jael Alexandre, Yasin Ali, Shanice Allen, Nanciana Amardi, Liliana Archidia, Crisanti Andrew, Jayla Andrews, Anaya Aruz, Teresa Maria Ariola, Aliyah Auder, Kama O'Point, Dana Babulal, Rose Angela Baez, Ashley Bailey, Raul J. Baker,
Ahmed Chek Bamba. Mokofoyo Bamedele. Kaylon Baptiste. Naomi Baptiste. Sarah Baptiste. Angelica Barnaby. Shamar Barry. Brianna Bartley. Nasaiba Battersfield. Trinisha Belgrave. Samantha Bellingy. Shirley Belval. Amber Ben. Ashley Ben. Kayla Bennett. Stephanie Bennett Ortiz. Evans Bernard. July Bienami. Brianna Blake. Please welcome Miss Marcia Trent.
Good day, Clawbottom students, staff, and parents. Congratulations to the class of 2020. You did it. I'm very proud of you. I know this virtual graduation is not what you expected. However, don't let it take away from your accomplishments and this moment. Let's celebrate. Congratulations again to the class of 2020. Stay safe and healthy. We are Barton Strong. Mr. Lion Boyer Vert. April Bashol. Audie Bourne. Shakai Brooks. Daniel Brown.
Kayla Brown.
Imani Brian Seaman. Shania Bryant. Sierra Calcano. Ashley Cardello. Jenny Castell. Christopher Celestine. Shania Chambers. Joshua Charles. Seven Charles. Sarah Christopher. Mariam Sis. Aretha Cletus. Kiera Cole. Kyla Cole.
Elijah Colson Reyes.
Michelle Collins. Shalena Collins. Tamala Conten. Candace Corlett. Kayla Crombie. Marlene Daniel. Marley Daniel. Nevaeh Davis. Sebastian Dissou. Hawali Diallo. Kumba Diawara. Nigel Dickey. Lahina Dormius. Kedman Dawsonville. Sarah Ann Dawsonville. Sanaya Dowlin. Cora Du Bois. Maureenie Dobinson. Helen Dyer. Brianna Easton. Anshanti Edwards. Brian Edwards. Akeem Alcock. Lahina Emmanuel.
Good day. This is Ms. Bansi. I want to wish the class of 2020 congratulations and good luck. Remember, the sky is the limit. Elaine Endeladze. Mame Erskine. Vetsa Etienne. Janatul Fordos. Ina Faustin. Deger Figaro. Morsonis Fields. Miguela Flemings. Colleen Fonbrun. Loé Forbes. Omar Ford. Alicia Forsyth. Gloria Francillon. Nayeli Francisco. Cristalina Francois. Candace Frank. Octavia Fulmore. Carrie-Anne Gaspard. Tiwonique Gale. Christina Gideon. Jonathan Gomez, Brianna Gordon, Danae Gordon, Erin Graham, Faith Grant, Maya Grant, Daphne Gray, Edward Gray, Chrysaline Green, Lensky Gregor, Talik Griffith, Tamiyu Guerrier, Jaden Gravel, Lincoln Hall, Kaya Hamilton, Brianna Hinkler, Ebony Hardy, Ashanti Hoggett, Amia Harper, Severin Hidoville, Olivia Henriquez, Kayla Henriquez Dunlap.
Good morning and congratulations to the class of 2020. I am Andrea Isaacs. I will continue with the listing of candidates for graduation. I wish you guys continued success. Stay safe and stay well. Aaliyah Henry. Michael Lee Henry.
Draquan Hilliard.
Jalen Hope Gillis. Krista Hospitalis. Jade Hudson. Kashauna Hunter Joyner. Aaron Moses Idowu. Anissa Ingram. Ariel Jack. Athalia Jack Richards. Brandon Jackson. Katharina Janvier. Guchin Jean. Gael Jean Francois. Alicia Jordan. Simone Jeremiah. Ashanti Johnson. Ashura Jones Cyrus. Shania Jordan. Emmanuel Joseph. Isaiah Joseph. Zipporah Joseph. Christian Juarez. Amani Kasim. Kayla Kelly. Shanique Laguerre. Bethsheena Lane. Taina Lalane. Bert Lancaster. Brianna Lawson. Paris Lee. Alyssa Lesko-Flair. Naya Lewis. Tiara Lindsay. Darren Lino. Cherise Lother. Christine Lockhart. Ciesha Lopez. Marie Lorme Just. Ashanti Lewis.
Gamel Lewis.
Giselle Lavelle. Maureen Lumos.
Aaliyah Major.
Congratulations, Clara Barton, class of 2020. What's up, guys? It's me, Mr. Neverson. Look, I'll admit this is not what we all had in mind when we thought of what our graduation would look like. But let's make the best of the situation. And despite all of the craziness that's been going on in the world and in our cities the past few months and weeks, let's just take this time just to celebrate with our friends and families all the accomplishments that you've made and the progress that you've made from freshman to senior year. And as you go on to the next chapter of your lives with college, military, career, just do your best, do your damnedest to make a positive impact on this crazy world. Okay, guys? All right, so stay Barton strong, all right, until we meet again. Peace.
Stanley Mathau. Celeste McKenzie. Miranda Mejia. Justin Mercurius. Luke Minot. Sabrina Murray, Kiara Moreno, Nyoka Morgan, Sabinelle Morin, Sarah Morrison, Terrence Mortel, DeAndre Mundell, Jalissa Myers Allen, Janital Nyam, Crystal Narain, Prescott Narcisse, Alan Nosey, Enola Olaleken, Layla Oliver, Benjamin Opoku, Yanelle Paisley, Latoya Parrish, Kayshawn Parsons,
Shakira Patrice Renee,
Linmaud Paul, Becky Paul Odianhin, Yoladine Paulerman, Melissa Polino, Kamasia Pierce, Blaise Pierre, Erica Pierre, Tiara Pierre Felix, Alinda Pierre Luis, Gabrielle Pinnock, Deborah Pluvials, Jilavinsa Pavali, Bianca Prophet, Amanda Raffington, Makia Reeves, Anissa Reed, Anasia Richards, Latoya Roberts, Mathia Roberts.
Class of 2020, you guys did it. You made it, you persevered, you pushed through, and you are finally here today on your graduation day. I am so proud of you. I can't wait to see what the future holds for you. Lots and lots of luck. Kayla Robinson, Jonathan Rocklin, Kisiwa Roxon, Alejandra Rodriguez, Tiffany Roman, Janaya Romero, Schneidine St. Hubert, Lisa Salvadon, Elizabeth Sani, Shanice Sherrod, Loa Thomason Shondinde, Kayla Slater, Sonia Smith, Israel Solano, Karen Spring, Delona Stewart,
Princess Sweat,
Fatumata Silla, Amy Sylvain, Leandra Tappan, Yamilet Tavares, Lydia Teague, Ashley Telemake, Yesenia Tutel Ramirez, Brianna Thomas, Kendra Thomas, Kayana Turen, Xiomara Valson, Kenil Vaughn, Nasla Velsi, Gastonia Victor, Sabina Victor, Tabitha Viljean, Kiana Wallace, Melvin Ward, Jessica Watson, Blessed Webb, Odell Welch, Brian White, Tiffany White, Esther Williams, Savannah Williams, Sky Wolf, Tahira Wright, Christopher Zamora, John A. Zephyrin.
Congratulations to all of the graduates. I present to you one more time our valedictorian, Ms. Shirley Belval, followed by Dr. Foreman.
Class of 2020, please rise. Be sure that your tassel is on the right side of your cap. The tassels on our caps symbolize our status as high school students. And as we move our tassels from right to left, we are signifying our transition from candidates to graduates.
You may now move your tassel from the right to the left. By the power vested in me by the New York City Department of Education and the New York State Board of Regents as principal of Clara Barton High School, I now declare you graduates of the Clara Barton High School Class of 2020. Congratulations.
Thank you, Dr. Foreman. Thank you, Shirley. I would like to welcome Ms. Becky Paul Adeonin, Student Government President, to acknowledge the staff members who are retiring this year.
Hello everyone, ready to class of 2020, friends and families. My name is Becky Paula Johan and I'm the 2020 Student Government President at Clara Barton High School. Yay! Students typically spend about 4 years in high school, and over the course of these 4 years, are privileged to go through various exceptionally dedicated teachers. But just as a student's time in high school ends, eventually it's just time when the high school comes to an end. It is therefore very important to ensure that when these teachers retire, we let them know that their contributions to the lives of many students and the school is greatly appreciated. With this fabulous graduating class of 2020, of which I am a part of, there are a few teachers who are also graduating in the form of retirement. These teachers are, firstly, Miss Ethel Ross, a science teacher. I personally don't know Miss Ross, but I've heard that she is a really good living environment teacher, and I therefore wish her the best in all her future endeavors. Secondly, Miss Doris Payne, a social studies teacher whom I also don't personally know, but I know that she was always willing to oversee club activities and was a prominent advocate for students. Her absence will be greatly felt, and I wish her all the best. Thirdly, Mr. Gardner, a social studies teacher and a dean. Mr. Gardner retired earlier this year in October, and he was a kind, understanding, sweet soul man. He treated all his students like as though they were his children, and made sure to have fun projects and snacks, so hunger was never a cause for us to not pay attention and learn. Mr. Gardner always had fun stories to tell, and he always seemed to be going on a diet, but he seemed to have been to almost every historical place there was. Mr. Gardner was an amazing teacher, and if he wasn't my teacher, I probably wouldn't have made as much headway as I did in the AP exam. Thank you, Mr. Gardner, sincerely. The last retiree is a teacher whose name I was shocked to see on this list. Miss Polly Denny Bishop, a physical education teacher and the track and field girls team coach. Coach Bishop has helped multiple kids over her years of service at Clara Barton High School achieve way more than they probably ever dreamed of achieving or intended to achieve. And for that, I say thank you. I could write an entire essay, heck, maybe even a book, on my experiences with Coach Bishop. And she has helped me in more ways, physically and mentally, than she probably even meant to. And I've learned a lot from Coach Bishop. Coach Bishop is truly an inspiration. Thank you. To all these wonderful retiring teachers, thank you for your service.
Thank you, Becky. I would like to say once again, congratulations and goodbye to the graduating class of 2020, both students and staff. At this time, I would like to call on Ms. Escoboris to say her goodbye.
Congratulations to the class of 2020. 4 years ago, you walked through our doors for the first time. And in these 4 years, you've come over many hurdles and many obstacles to get to this day, your graduation day. When you continue in life to jump those hurdles and conquer all those obstacles, come back. Let us know what you've done because we want to continue to celebrate you. Our door is always open. This is not goodbye, just farewell for now. Congratulations.
Good day and greetings, class of 2020. Please take a second to spend your last few moments as high school students by thinking back to those memories of Clara Barton High School from the last 4 years. Now, normally, I ask you guys to turn to your neighbor and congratulate them as well. But unfortunately, we will not be able to do that today. So what I'm going to ask you to do is please give them a call or send them a text. Now, I thought about the last few days, how I should address you and what I should do. So I figured the best way is, why not just do what I've been doing every morning for the last 4 years of your high school career, well, except until March 13th, and that is to start off with the morning announcement. So you guys ready? Here we go. Good morning, Clara Barton. Today is Friday, June 26, 2020, and now the morning announcements. I have a few brief announcements today. First, congratulations to the class of 2020, and what an amazing job you guys did. Just amazing. So this year we have gone through many changes. 2020 was the year that I thought I'd see big things happen. Instead, we were dealt a global pandemic, racial injustices, and an uneasiness throughout the world. Since when did we have virtual graduations, online classes using Google Classroom for the norm, and just the way of life that is different? Well, guess what? You stood up to the challenges. If you could get through this, you could get through anything. You are our future, and guess what? It's looking bright. I am so proud to say that I was able to teach some of you and get to know you on a personal level these past few years. Now, I'm sad to say goodbye like this, so instead I'm going to say see you later. Now, I'm hoping that that later will be in person so that I could give you a handshake or a hug. Make us proud, but most importantly, do it for you. Make yourself proud with what you do in the future. I am sure this won't be the last time you hear from me. And when I'm in a store or even on vacation, because yes, you found me in the middle of the ocean on a cruise, please come over, say hello. I'd love to see you guys again. I am going to definitely miss you. Congratulations to the class of 2020. So, I don't know. Is there anything else that I need to say? I'm not sure. Is there something else I need to say? Yeah, tell me, whisper. Oh, yes, Josh just reminded me. So, if you guys are ready and you know it, please repeat along with us. Those are the announcements for today. Make sure you go into all your classes, behave in hallways, and...
Have a great day, Barton.
Have a great day, Barton. Congrats, 2020.
Good.
And now, welcome Esther and Ajmani to pass along the colors.
We, the class of 2020, pass the colors to the class of 2021.
Thank you, Esther. My name is Ajmani Witter, and on behalf of the class of 2021, we accept these colors.
Well, that about wraps it up, folks. Just want to say a few last goodbyes and some thank yous. So thank you to Esther and Ajmani for passing the colors. We just want to say from our homes to yours, congratulations to the class of 2020. We wish you nothing but success, and it has been a pleasure having you as our students. Come back for Alumni Day. Hopefully school will be open. Hopefully. So I want to thank Dr. Foreman, our teachers, our guidance counselors, our assistant principals, our support staff, school safety agents, parents and the PTA, custodians, Shay and Jeff from the LIU Gear Up program, and the entire LIU Gear Up family. I want to thank our school nurses, our paras, secretaries, my production team of students, including Lydia Teague, thank you so much, Ms. Sapan and Mr. Kinlock, my school aides, thank you guys, I see you, our cafeteria staff, Ms. Gisette says hi, and P.O. Smith and P.O. Adams, ladies, thank you so much for having that support group. We love you for having that. Please come back and help support our students some more once school opens back up. I want to thank Ms. Escoboris, our parent coordinator, Ms. Lawson, and congratulations on Brianna graduating. Mr. Holgate, our host, what would we have done without you? And of course, Mr. Nerison with the alumni band, what an amazing job they did. So we're going to listen to them one more time, because guess what? Without them, this would have never happened. So please enjoy one last time our alumni ensemble. Those are all we have. That's all I have for today. So everyone, once again, have a great day, Barton. Take care.
Wait, so y'all really telling me this is all over?
Yeah, I think so. No, it's over. I already passed over the colors. And Mr. Morrison said, have a great day, Barton. It's been real 2020. This was great, even though we were home.
It was. No, it's true. It's all true. We are in a virtual world. And you were there. And you were there. And you.
Yes, Ms. Sagan, we said that, but it's okay. We are class of 2020. We are Barton Strong.
Well, guys, I'm about to socially distance away from y'all.
Bye. Bye. Take care.
Bye. 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 Bye.
See you in the future.
Barton, I can't leave.
You know what, Kinlock? They will be great. They are amazing, and they are so strong.
They were a great class. Congrats, 2020. Okay, Safin, it's June 26th. I'm on summer vacay. Stay safe.
Bye, Kinlock. Stay safe. Congrats, class of 2020.
Hey, where are you? There's no one there. Hello? They did it to me again. They left. I hate virtual meetings.